Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Our speaker for the evening, Dr. K. Shivaram, Vice President Naushad Panjwani, Santosh Jain, Past President Pranay Bhai Marfatia, and friends. At the outset, I wish each one of you very happy and prosperous 2013. In last 2 days, many of you would have gone through the prediction page to know what is in store for the in the coming year. You can add one more prediction from my side, that there will be stress and anxiety on account of recovery spree by the tax department on your clients, as a result of which you will not be able to recover your legitimate dues of past 2-3 years. Friends, disputes in tax matters is a natural outcome in any tax system, but more so when a tax happens to be as complicated as ours. We have learned to live with litigation and high-handedness of tax administrators. The recovery provisions are the most unpleasant and dreaded provisions of the Act. It is becoming a common practice to raise high-pitched demands by framing assessments at a substantial higher amount than the returned income. Many unjust orders have been passed and taxpayers have to pay heavy price and face undue hardship and even sometimes irreparable loss. The amount demanded, if not paid within the stipulated time, the taxpayer would be said to be assessee in default. The tax officer may then proceed for recovery of taxes by invoking coercive measures. When it comes to recovery through coercive steps, the taxman can get to the skin, brushing aside the fact that the courts have time and again stressed that tax officers should be judicious rather than overzealous in recovery proceedings. The bureaucrats, on the other hand, try to dilute the original guidelines issued under Instruction No. 96, which were favoring taxpayers, by issuing circulars and subsequent instructions. The ways and means of collecting the demands are getting harsh. The situation in coming months may get worse, as it was reported that the estimated figures of total direct tax collection is short of budget estimates. As a result, in coming months, the department will hotly pursue the past demands and demands of current assessments to meet the target. Friends, speaking of the targets, how can we forget communication dated 7th February 2012, issued by Chairman of CBDT to all CCITs, DGITs, CITs and DITs, linking revenue collection to the performance parameters of the tax officers and also giving importance to the same while considering future placements. This would compound the hardship. To add the woes of taxpayers, the CAG has tabled a report before the Parliament pointing out that income tax officials have been sitting on cases instead of initiating prompt action to collect outstanding tax dues, and has left the Income Tax Department for not taking effective steps to recover tax arrears owed to the government, which have shot up to 2.3 lakh crore, which is almost half of the country's total direct tax collection. In past, we have seen that in the drive to collect the demand, assessing officers by a summary order rejects the request of stay demand made by the assessee, and this would continue in this year under the guise of CAG report and short collection. Experience says that the guidelines and the principles let down by courts are generally given a bypass by the tax officials while trying to enforce the demands which are incorrectly raised and or can be easily rectified. And the instructions and circulars for tax officers to exercise discretion in stay matters judiciously are being ignored out. In that context, sir, one poser that like assessee in default, is there anything in the Act like officer in default? But some hope is there, as of late, the courts have had an occasion to deal with various aspects of the matters relating to the stay of demand. And in many cases, they have granted relief to various types of assessees, right from multinational company to public sector undertakings, charitable trust and individuals, which is very encouraging for those taxpayers whose matter is strong in merits. So, with the way the department is going ahead with recovery of tax and stay, it has become necessary to aware of the rights and remedies under the law and understand the recent rulings on the subject and be geared up for the challenges. And to deal with this and various other issues, as well as the factual points, one should take care while filing the stay application, and where the taxpayer needs to stand up and take appropriate action, we have this evening with us Dr. K. Shivaram. Dr. K. Shivaram is LLM and PhD law. He is practicing as counsel before Bombay High Court and Income Tax Appellate Tribunal since 1978. He is member of Core Committee, Tax Matters, Bombay High Court, drafting of the High Court rules for filing appeals in tax matters. He is President of Income Tax Appellate Tribunal Bar Association, Mumbai, past President of All India Federation of Tax Practitioners of India during 2003 to 2005, past President of the Chamber of Tax Consultants from 1990 to 1992. He is Chief Editor of AFTP Journal, former editor of Income Tax Review published by the Chamber of Tax Consultants. He has authored number of publications and delivered lectures in India and abroad. He is a member of Regional Direct Taxes Advisory Committee, Government of India, since from 1992 to 1996. Friends, I would now request Naushad Panjwani to offer a memento to Dr. K. Shivaram as a token of our respect and appreciation.
Deepak Karsha, Marish Naushad Panjwani, Vice President, Mr. Santosh Jain, Past President, Apatya, Mr. Naik, and seniors, many are there, and Mr. Vyas, I think I one of the very senior member of the BCA. Ladies and gentlemen, in fact, you know, I thought of thanking Mr. Deepak Shah for giving me this opportunity for this reason that otherwise would not have an opportunity to wish you all of you at one place you have been here. Because this is the rarest rare opportunity, so that let me thank him for giving this opportunity. Those who are here, those who could not make it, those who are likely to see in the web form also, I wish them, all of them, a very happy and very prosperous New Year's. Friends, the recovery is one of the very important subject in direct taxation, which all of us are very much concerned in our day-to-day practice, either as a consultant or when dealing with our own taxation matters. I must say that the president and his team rightly selected this subject at the right time, because the maximum recovery proceeding will be there in the month of January, February and March. In fact, one of the very well-known counsel once told us on the recovery, he said that recovery is such a way that if you raise the bill to your client, if you are not able to recover, that is bad debt, that is not the good method of raising the bill. Similarly, the income tax department also, if you are able to raise the tax, if they are not able to recover, that is as good as like you are raising the bill and not able to recover from your clients. The law of recovery based on civil procedure code 1908. Therefore, the knowledge of civil procedure code relating to recovery will help us to make better representation, render better correct advice on the when issue comes for the discussion concerned. The subject of recovery is very, very vast. To discuss all the important subject, possibly may require at least one day workshop. So with the limited time of 1 hour and 15 minutes, I will discuss only few important issues which may be relevant in our day-to-day practice. What I have divided for today's discussion is concerned, my subject will be in 7 parts. First part, I will deal with the recovery before assessment. Second part, I will deal with the recovery after assessment, then joint and several liability, remedies again required before various authorities, some general issues, suggestion, and finally interaction with the learned chartered accountant on the issues what they come across with day-to-day practice concern. Now the recovery proceedings before the assessment, that is called the provisional assessment. Under Civil Procedure Code, it is called the attachment before judgment. Now we will see the circular 179 that has been, when they introduce the provision, they categorically stated that what is the purpose of this provision. In fact, inbuilt, the section has been inbuilt provision to safeguard the excessive or the excess what officers may do in the course of assessment is concerned. What they say that this is that ultimately the the officer may use some coercive method to recover the tax that is not permitted as per the section is concerned, as per circular is concerned. Now section makes it very clear, section 281B, what it says that the during pendency of any proceeding for the assessment or assessment. This can be invoked only during the pendency of the assessment proceeding, not after the assessment proceedings are completed. Now the for understanding this, one may look at the Supreme Court judgment, that is 2 SCC 302, that is the judgment of the FX court, that is Raman Tech and Process Engineering Company versus Solanki, 2 SCC. What the court dealing with the your civil procedure code, that is the civil act 281B, what is stated that the such power should not be exercised mechanically or merely for asking. It should be used sparingly and strictly accordance with the rule. Purpose of rule 38 is not to convert the unsecured debt in the secured debt. Any attempt by the plaintiff, that is under civil procedure code, utilize the provisions of the rule 38 as a leverage, coercing, defaulting, settle the suit, provision of should be discouraged. This is the principle laid down under civil procedure. Same principle apply for the income tax also, because wordings are identical here. Now once we know this principle, then we have to say that the provisional attachment must be in writing, and it should be have been reasoned and with the passed with the approval of the higher authority. That is what the 245 ITR 169, that is the Calcutta High Court, Gaurav Goyal versus CIT. Now the another principle laid down by the Allahabad High Court, that is Raghuram Gra Private Limited versus ITU 281-147. What is said that before passing 281B, the officer has to look into like the basic fast defaults. It is not that mechanically some they want attack, they want to see that how the conduct of the SSC, is he fastly defaulted or is he that the good SSC, then only they can the use the provision under section 281 the B is concerned. Otherwise they cannot be invoked into section 281 B is concerned. Now the next case on the subject is 187-86-42, that is the Srimati Maju versus ACIT. What is said that the provisional attachment valid only for period of 6 months unless extended. Then they said our provisional assessment cannot exceed more than 2 years. Maximum it can permit about 2 years. That also with the permission of the commissioner is concerned. Then that the Punjab High Court has gone the this extent 6 months plus 2 years, 2.5 years. That is the only one High Court has taken the view that it could be maximum 2.5 years, or otherwise the Madras High Court, all the High Court has taken that maximum for 2 years only, including 6 months are concerned. Now the once we understood the section 281B, because now I am dealing with only section 281B is concerned. Now the property which can be attached, what are properties can be attached? Now the issue came before the Madras High Court, 186 CTR 286 C Subramaniam versus ACIT. What is said that in the case of joint owned property, only undivided share of SSC can be attached provisionally, not the entire property. Suppose the property is in joint name of the SSC and his wife, they cannot attach entire property. If it is joint property, they can attach only his share as one fifth concerned, not the half share is concerned, not the entire property. Similarly, the issue came before the Punjab Narayan High Court, that is the 248 ITR 785, Satyabir Singh versus CIT, fixed the post name of the HF. Only share of SSC can be attached, not the entire fixed deposit. Suppose HF property is there, individual karta had defaulted, then the provisional attachment only to this extent, not the entire fixed deposit can be attached. In fact, the in the 278 ITR, that is the Calcutta High Court, Electro Javed India Private Limited 187, where the court go on to this extent, while dealing with the property was sold and it was not registered, and the transferee taken the possession. Meantime, there was recovery proceeding against that the seller. The department attached property. The High Court said that nothing doing, because the 281B cannot be initiated attached property. Registration and income tax is not the relevant. under income tax for capital gain is concerned, the possession is important, not the registration. Therefore, that we request the entire proceeding under section 281B is concerned. Then the Gandhi Trading Company, that is jurisdiction like court, that is Bombay, versus Gandhi Trading versus ACIT 239/83/37 Bombay. What it says that as far as possible 281B can be invoked only respect of the immovable properties, not against fixed deposit or other movable assets are concerned. That is the principle laid down by the Bombay court. They say that it can be invoked only to the immovable property, not to the movable properties are concerned. Now in case assessment is completed and you have filed the appeal and the appellate authority has given the, let us say, conditions stay, we pay certain installment, then 281B cannot be invoked, such an action is contrary to the law. That is what laid down by the full bench, the 100 STC 270, that is API code, the Shah Wallace & Company Limited versus ITO, that they say dealing with sale tax, principle is the same. They say that you cannot continue 281B is concerned. Now, only thing is that the section, assuming that 281B is initiated and order is passed, what remedy you have? Your only remedy is to go to the High Court under Article 226 of the Constitution of India. Therefore, that the only remedy is that the writ petition against the 281B is concerned. Now, the next issue comes, this is the what preliminary issue of 281B is concerned. No doubt the very, very few, you may have to deal with only few matters, only 281B is concerned. Now the recovery proceeding after assessment, this is the what we have, all of us are concerned. In fact, Deepak also mentioned beginning, SSC in default, whether can be possible SSC officer in default. The question may come after some time. Now you see who can be declared an SSC in default. Now you see there are certain sections dealing with that. Of course, I will not refer to all of you must have read the sections, so I will not read the various sections what we can deal with that. That is the various sections involved on that. I may deal with only one provision. You see, assuming that the assessment order is passed, we are not looking into the validity of the assessment order. Once the assessment order is passed, the notice issued under 156, and if the SSC does not pay that amount within 30 days, he is treated SSC in default. But the condition is that there has to be notice of demand under section 156. But in case of the order under 179, that is the director treating him as a defaulter, there need not be any 156. Simple order 179. Similarly, the section 220, subsection 4, there cannot be any notice of demand. Similarly, 140A3, there cannot be notice of demand. And similarly, for section 200, there cannot be notice of demand. Once the order is passed, automatically, if you don't pay within the 30 days, be treated as SSC in default is concerned. Recently, we have come across very, very recently where the company has filed return of income, then the company has not paid the self-assessment tax. Few days back, the SSC, the principal officer of the company, that is the managing director, issued a notice for the prosecution is concerned. They said if you don't pay the prosecution, if we don't pay the amount, we will be liable to prosecution under section 276C, it will be section 278B. The director being the well-known person and in the company has no money to make the payment, the question asked us what to do. We told them that all right, if you have no money in your company, borrow and make the payment. Reason being very simple. That tomorrow once they launch the prosecution against that particular director, the media trial will start, then it become very difficult for him to answer all the questions. And apart from that, section 278E, that is prosecution is concerned, burden is on him to prove that beyond reasonable doubt that why he not made a payment. So considering all that, sometimes it may be very essential for us to, though you are legally a good case or you may not able to pay, sometimes advise the SSC make the payment. And by the fees is concerned, this is what the possibly your SSC also may receive where they not paid the advance, what if not self-assessment tax, you may receive the notice for the prosecution directly without notice of demand is concerned. Now the valid service of notice. That is what the Supreme Court said. That is the Mohan Y versus CIT. Supreme Court, valid service is mandatory. Failure to serve the notice required proceeding held to be not valid. Here the what the court says that the in the absence of the valid service, though you must have passed the order, if it is not, then the entire proceeding will become invalid. That is the principle laid down by the Supreme Court is concerned. Demand notice, not deficiency, held to be invalid is concerned. Now the question came before the 347 at 161 Gujarat. There also similar principle are laid down. If there is no demand, there is no valid notice, then the entire proceeding can be quashed. Then the notice as regard the MP High Court in 238/591, that is Satandas Mohandas Siddhi, it says that the mandated that notice must served only in the manner provided in section 282, and the notice by telegram could not be directed to be substituted by the post. The notice was sent by telegram. They said that is not substituted. It has to be by the provided section 282 of the Income Tax Act only. So we have to read the, when they receive the notice, is it as per the section 282 of the 282 of the Act. Okay. Okay, General Clauses Act, you know, the section 27 of the General Clauses Act deals with the meaning of service by post. It is sent by registered post, then only it is called the service by the post. Acknowledgement produce, the presumption is that the proper service. That is what the Calcutta High Court in the Malchand Surana 28-684 Calcutta. Now you see that the Bombay High Court, which we referred it over there, that is the AIR 1968 Bombay 387, which affirmed by the Supreme Court, I think that something is technical. Yes, it is filed by technology, you know, sometimes. Okay, is the Supreme Court in the AIR 1976-869, that is the Udva Venkateshwar Rao, what he said, suppose the department said that we have served the notice. Presumption is that it is as per General Clauses Act, it is served properly on the address given. Now, burden shift on the SSC to show that it has not been issued by him. So, they have only one alternative, they file the affidavit and then show that, demonstrate that the it has been not served, then only that the burden shift back once again on the department to show that notice was not properly served. Otherwise, it is presumed that notice has been properly served. Now, you see, if you see the, like the, when it is notice served on the person, it has to be served on the adult member of the. Now, you see, very interestingly, the Order 5, Rule 15 of the CPC, that is Civil Procedure Code, which I referred, they have given explanation, a servant is a not member of family. Within the meaning of rule, therefore, if a service is of notice on the servant, it is not a valid service. Suppose by any chance, if you are not there, the officer or the who give the notice to the servant, and according to them, the service is not the service to the servant, is not valid service, that is, they have to strictly follow the rules as concerned. That is what the rule, that is what the section says that very clearly, service to the servant is not an. I am referring for this reason. Suppose you see by any chance that in legally you have no good case, at least sometimes, you know, at least some technical issues may help you to find out that yes, at least something service is not good, therefore entire at least you are able to buy certain times for the giving the reply or for the making proper arrangement. Now you see that the next issue is that the shorten the period. As I mentioned earlier, 30 days period has to be given to the SSC to make the payment. But can the AO say that, all right, though we are given 30 days time, I will restrict only for 7 days. So within 7 days, you are supposed to make the payment is concerned. For the year, the full bench, that is of the API court, M. Redanna, Redanna versus Revenue, 46 STC 232 full bench. What he says that the you cannot reduce it to the 7 days. You have to give the full 30 unless some very basic genuine. Okay, unless there is some very something very drastic reason is that SSC is running away, something like that. Otherwise they say that it is not possible to reduce the, that is what full bench is concerned. Similarly, that the jurisdictional High Court, that is the Mahindra and Mahindra, that reported in 59 ELT 505 Bombay, the court held that the no action should be taken till they expire the actual period against the SSC, and the assessing officer bound to wait till the appeal period for 30 days are over, then only can proceed with the, otherwise he cannot proceed to recover the taxes concerned. Similarly, the judicial High Court Mahindra and Mahindra, that is the 295 ITR 43, there also, in fact, the court gone to this extent that the here the officer had not followed the direction, then the court gone to the extent why contempt action should not be taken to the assessing officer for not following the direction of the principle laid down by the judicial High Court is concerned. Why I am referring for this reason? Like, you know, suppose the when you give the when you appear before assessing officer for the stay of your recovery, yes, 295 ITR, we are dealing with that. Okay. Now you know that why I am referring for this reason. The I had occasion to appear before the earlier days before one of the commissioner appeal, and then you know that the issue was directly covered by the tribunal. When I pointed out to him that this is judgment is there of the jurisdictional tribunal, he said if you don't follow, it may amount to contempt. The commission appeal said, all right, you show us the one instance where the you could have taken action against contempt for not following the order of the High Court or the tribunal. Of course, I had no answer. I said, all right, sir, we have not taken action, but I put your submission in writing. Then I wrote detailed submission before the commission appeal, stating that this is all the case laws on subject, and if you don't follow this, that will amount contempt. To surprise, ultimately order came in favor of the SSC is concerned. So therefore, the contempt is concerned. It may not, we may not be able to take the action, but definitely that will help you that the impress upon the officer, if you don't follow that order of the judicial High Court, judicial tribunal, it may amount to the contempt of the court is concerned. Now the, that is what the judicial High Court laid that the, similarly the, what I referred it over here that the, in the Furos 10 also, that is the 71 DTR, there also the officer asked them to pay within 7 days. Court said nothing doing that. If you have to wait for 30 days, you cannot ask them to make the payment within the period of the 7 days. Now you know what are the consequences. Suppose this is the what the if you don't, rare that case I think they may impress upon you to make the payment. Otherwise normally they may give 30 days. And if you don't make the payment, then what are the consequences? The consequence will be the mandatory interest, penalty, attachment, appointment receiver and the prosecution of arrest is concerned. Now let me deal with the few issues on the reply applications to keep the demand in abeyance. Normally what we find that the 80% of the your replies, means what we give the reply, that we simply say that I have filed appeal and keep the demand in abeyance. That is what the normally almost all the SSC write like that. But my submission will be that is not the correct reply. According to me, you should give detailed reply stating that how the assessment order is not correct, how we assessing officer not followed judicial high court if it is there in judgment on that, how we not followed judgment of Supreme Court. Then you also say that what are financial difficulties, and you explain them what will be the chances of succeeding in appeal for the, and then the, if at all you have to say that all right, based on the judgment I have a fair chance of succeeding, therefore keep the demand in abeyance. And then you may also write in the last that the, all right, if you don't keep the demand in abeyance, give me one more opportunity of the hearing is concerned. If you write these, the possibility may be very difficult for him to reject your application outright. Otherwise, what will happen that the if you simply write that you are in appeal, he will say that you are not given any reasoning. Tomorrow, assuming if you attach bank account, if you oppose the court, he said you are not given any explanation. So how court will help you on this? So we looking at all this, my advice will be you have to give the detailed reply, then only the your chances of getting the relief from the IR, it will be very, very good. Now is the how the officer has to use the discretion. Now this is the 251 IPR 158, that is KS International Limited, BR Balakrishnan. There you know the Bombay High Court laid down certain parameters. It is worth seeing what are the parameters. What the Bombay High Court says that the authority concerned set out the case of authority before rejecting, they should say the what are the facts. Then the why return income is much higher than asset income, then the asset income much higher than return income, then what will be difficulties, then the financial difficulties, and also examine whether time power expired or not. Thereafterwards, the authority concerned comply with the above parameters. Thereafter only they can reject your application. They say the court also gone to this extent. These are all not exhaustive. They are only recommended in nature. Though court say recommended, that is binding on the officer is concerned. So whenever you give the reply, first you have to see, are you complying with the direction of the judicial high court 251 ITR? That is the first point you have to check up. If you are complying with that, then you can say that our issue is covered by the DC parameters and falling within the parameters. Then I don't think any officer will say that no, we still have to take the action. Then similarly, Coca-Cola, that is 285-419, there also attached bank account before communicating the order held to be very bad. That I have been questioned. Then once again, you know that the Bombay High Court laid down the guidelines in the case of the in the case of the UTI mutual fund, that is 345 ITR 71, what court gone to this statement that they say that when the appeal is pending, you should not expire a time limit, you cannot dispose of stay petition, you cannot, what do you mean to say, suppose you file the stay petition, if it not disposed of, they cannot recover. Then the what they say that the bank account, you should not assume it attached, you should not withdraw it, because it should take sufficient time to go approach the higher authorities, and the they should ask like can the public duty protect the interest of the revenue, so therefore that the they should act very balanced way, then only they can recover. This is the what the principle very last year only the judicial high court related mutual fund is concerned. Then you will also find that the similarly the Tata Toyo Radiator Private Limited, then Nishit Mandal Desai, then the Rajasthani Sammelan, all these cases the similar guidelines has been given. The court is go on repeating that the, in fact the one of the case, that is the where in the Rajasthani Sammelan, where the not reported, what the court made observation that the, as in several cases which come before this court, particular month of March, it is evident that the AODIT both had regard to the parameters which have been laid down by this court 51 ITR, they said that we direct them to, they should follow the strictly the parameters. So now this year when you reply, all the case laws available to you to consider that whether to, which are the case laws has to be considered and which are to be looked into while giving the reply to the assessing officer is concerned. Now similarly, of course, this is the jurisdictional tribunal is concerned, what they say RPG industries, they also say that they said how the discretion to be utilized, and then they say that the application pending even for the tribunal, they should not recover the money is concerned. And the you will also find like the other high courts, in fact 81 ITR, why I referred it for 81 ITR for limited purpose, it say that assuming you are financially very sound, till they say that that cannot be the criteria to just to recover the money. He said that financial sound, permission to pay is not itself ground for refusal access. He should have the merit of a good case, then also that cannot be the ground only for refusing the application for stay is concerned. Similarly, that the other high courts, 337 and 892, these are other high courts which are just made reference to just for your guidelines are concerned. Otherwise, the principle is the same. In fact, to the 346 ITR, Rajasthan High Court has gone to this extent that if the asset income is 47 times, is bound to stay the proceeding. Therefore, that is what the principle laid down by the Rajasthan High Court. In fact, what the instruction the learned friend referred, Mr. Deepak referred earlier, that has been considered once again over here. They say that that should be looked into while considering the appeal is concerned. Now the one other criteria, when you go appeal to the state, appeal is concerned, your appeal should be that the valid appeal. Suppose if your appeal is delayed, can it be said the valid appeal is pending? Answer is no. Because the appeal is not filed on due date and within 30 days, if it is pending for admission, it is not a valid appeal. Once you condone the delay, then only become valid appeal is concerned. Therefore, you have to be very cautious that when you go in appeal, that should be appeal should be valid appeal pending before the authorities are concerned. Now similarly, suppose if you not paid admitted tax, what I mentioned earlier, your appeal is not maintainable at all. Therefore, before going to appeal, you have to see that you have to pay the admitted tax. Of course, interest is not admitted tax, interest is not the tax, that is what the court have laid down. Therefore, these two points which we have to bear in mind, should be valid appeal and should be filed in time. Then only you can approach the officer recovery concern if your appeal is. Other way of that, suppose if a delay is there, one way could be you should approach the commission appeal, at least consider my application for the condonation of delay and pass the order, then that will become valid appeal is concerned. Let me also share with you one point, of course nothing to do with your recovery is concerned. Now you know that most of the appeals what we draft, we write the grounds, but normally we don't give the statement of fact elaborately. So that is what we found, that when the matter goes to the High Court only sees what you have given before the first appeal. Because tribunal when you go, there is no statement of facts at all. You cannot give any statement of fact. Only forum where you can give the detailed statement of fact before the CAT appeal. And if you don't give the CAT appeal the proper statement of facts, including that why this order is bad, what wrong he has committed, when he goes High Court appeal, the High Court will ask us where you challenge. That is very difficult. Therefore, I thought of referring over here, though it is not relating to this recovery is concerned, that will definitely help you with the as regard when the matter goes further appeal is concerned. Now the mere filing an appeal cannot be the only ground that the stay application should be granted. That is what the Supreme Court says, that application for disputed demand before expiry of the time is concerned, then only they can do it. Otherwise, merely filing appeal doesn't mean that your stay will be granted automatically. Similarly, also principle laid down in the Madras High Court 28 ITR 676 and also 256 ITR 754 Calcutta is concerned, which I referred it over here. They also say that the similar is also taken the view is concerned. Now can there be recovery in the protective assessment? Now there are three judgments on this. What they say that 139 ITR 880, Sunil Kumar. Then the Jagannath Bawari, 234 ITR, Kawati. Then 31 ITR 603 and 207 ITR 256, Madras. All these courts are taken as you. There could be protective assessment, but cannot be protective recovery person. That is the protective recovery. Now, interestingly, there is judgment of the 191 ITR 179. There you see that the courts have taken the stand. Suppose you file 154 application, that is not disposed of. According to the court, that the when application is pending, assessing officer cannot proceed with the recovery proceeding. That means, let us, for example, he made patent mistake in the order, you also go in appeal, meantime you also file 154. According to this court, that the 154 is pending, he cannot recover at all till he dispose of the application under 154 is concerned. This is only one judgment on this particular issue is concerned. Now the garnish proceeding required from third parties, 226(3) is concerned. That is the, where you see that the normally here the courts laid down that the when they can start the 226(3) proceeding, after 30 days definitely they can start. But beyond, before 30 days they cannot start. But the Supreme Court says that 296 ITR 31, that is the administrator UTI BM Malani, what it says that the legal fiction created when an amount is not payable, such a person not required to pay such an amount or part thereof units. Means suppose the department issue 226(3), the amount is not payable to you as on particular date. Department cannot compel that SSE to make payment to you till that becomes due to you. That is what the Supreme Court has laid down. Similarly, the Allahabad High Court 340 ITR say that fixed deposit third parties attachment is not valid. That is what the Calcutta High Court has laid down the principle. Then similarly, the again the garnish award is concerned, the assessing officer can approach to the officer to withdraw it. If he doesn't do it, then only alternative left with you is approaching once again under Article 226 to the Constitution before the High Court is concerned. Now you see that the when the appeal is pending, recovery officer should prohibit it not against the creditor. The court stayed prohibited and can bona fide assessee on the condition paying installment. Sometimes the court put the condition that all right, you garnish proceeding can be stayed with a certain condition. In the matter of the Bombay High Court, that is the 259 ATR, what SSC contended that they all right, garnish notice issued, they say that all right, I have to repay the loan to back to him, therefore that the 15 lakh rupees is there, but I am not ready to pay because I have to repay the loan. But the court said nothing doing, that is the rent is concerned, you are liable to be paid, your repayment loan is nothing with the department dues are concerned, therefore you have to pay to the department as regard the rent is concerned. That is what the lawyer laid down on the garnish proceeding is concerned. Now the Karnataka High Court, that is the 241 ITR 178, both the Karnataka High Court, they have gone to this extent. Suppose fixed deposit with the bank is not yet mature, but it can be attached and recovered by the department. That is what the Karnataka High Court has taken the stand, that it can be recovered. Similarly, rent payable by a tenant is a debt which can be recovered, subject matter of the, that is what the Supreme Court has laid down, that the income tax authorities, both these cases, the Supreme Court said that rent recovered, rent can be recovered and can be attached by the under section 226(c) is concerned. Now the interesting issue comes over here, that the time bar debt, it cannot be recovered, assuming that even SSC will be happy to let the department attach. The court said that no, you cannot do it. Now the property which cannot be recovered, that is very interesting. You see that as per rule 10(1), second schedule of income tax act, all such property, the code of civil procedure, what I referred it earlier, exempted from the attachment of the sale. They are given the various list. So few list, while I thought of just referring only some of them, like the necessary wearing apparel, personal ornament of woman, tools, house occupied by agriculturist, deposit public provident fund and insurance, money payable by insurers. These are all the various, we can look into that, that room, then you will be able to know that the dissolved properties which cannot be attached at all, whatever may be the reason, assuming SSG agrees, till it cannot be attached. Of course, stock exchange, that was at the 11th time it was the case and which can be attached is concerned. Now the property of the sum which cannot be attached by, that is what the 331 IT of 278, that they rate that property of the sun is concerned, it cannot be attached by the officer for the recovery of the tax of the father is concerned. Interestingly, that we will also find there in the rule, residential property covered under rent control is exempt from the attachment. We will find that in Mumbai, that is the commonly known as pagadi, whereas the property is covered under pagadi, can it be attached or not, though it is valuable right. The Delhi High Court, dealing with the commercial property, as the residence is concerned, very clear, it cannot be attached at all. As the commercial is concerned, the Delhi High Court, that is the AR 1993 430, shop was there, it was covered under Rent Act, the department under debtor wanted to attach it. The Delhi High Court says that no, though specifically not exempt, till you cannot attach. Because according to Delhi High Court, that the unless the consent of the landlord is obtained, we will not be able to recover. But unfortunately, we are having the judgment of the full bench of the jurisdictional High Court, that is the Thangarani Electronic System, that is AIR, that is the full bench of the Bombay High Court, AIR 2198. What he said, that interest of the lessee of the leasehold building, clause 7c, he said it can be attached. That is the commercial property concern, it can be attached. That is what the judicial high court has said, that so therefore commercial property is there, though it is rented, the equity is your transferable rent is there, transferable right in the property, possibly that right can be attached of the Bombay High Court full bench is concerned. Now the salary of the debtor cannot be attached. Then the old debt at the bank, that is what the 33 IT 26 old judgment, he says that the that cannot be attached at all. What debt is there, that cannot be attached at all. Now the recovery from the director 179, that is very, nowadays most of the cases you will find that the director private limited is concerned, they are issuing the notice to the director to recover the tax from the company's concern. Now all these cases you will find that the provision can be made only when the assessing officer cannot recover from the company. That is what principle laid down, and the thereafter what officer has to pass the order under 179, then only it can be recovered. That is the KV Reddy 238 ITR 253 ITR, all these cases where they laid down that principle is concerned. Then the before the director, revenue must prove that the director were responsible for conduct of the business, that revenue has to prove, then only. And the officer has to hear the director before passing 179 order. That is the what the courts have laid down. Then the suppose the company is not agitating that order, assessment order, whatever the reason. Then the director is has to abide by that order unless he separately challenges that. Otherwise, he cannot agitate in 179 order. Know that they could have filed appeal, they are not filed appeal. So therefore, that the I will not be responsible. That is what the jurisdictional High Court said, 172 ITR, the one is concerned. Director, liability of director is only respect of the when you are the director, not otherwise. Now the when private company converted into limited company, from rate of conversion there will not be any liability. That is what the Supreme Court says, 195 ITR 873. Now what will be the remedy? Suppose 117 order is passed, you have no remedy, you can approach the commissioner, or you have only remedy is going to approach to the High Court under Article 226 writ petition is concerned. Now interestingly, you know that the one of judgment, that is the Upatlal Desha, that is the Nutrition High Court. Why it says that, you know, interestingly, he was a non-executive director and resigned from the board much earlier, and for the old assessment year, the 179 was passed. He opposed the commissioner rejected. Then his plea before the commission assessing, all right, you are trying to recover from me. That company is the partner in the partnership firm. They had about 80% shares in that firm. That firm has the huge assets. So first you oppose that, then you come back to me. But that was rejected by the commissioner. When he went to the High Court set aside the order of the commissioner. High Court said that nothing doing. You approach to the first to the company, then approach the partnership firm. You are not able to recover, then only you have to be recovered from the, you can be recovered from the director is concerned. Why I am referring for this reason, you know that the many times, you know that we have come across the one of the leading lawyer who is the director in the some of the companies. On fine morning, he also received the notice from the magistrate court for the company had not paid the taxes at all. He realized that though he resigned earlier, but still he has to appear before the court. Then you have to plead before them, I resigned such and such date, and I am more and more concerned with that. The company not filed the, this is how the the when the company runs away, all these problems will come to the directors are concerned. Now you see that similarly, you will also find the firm and partners, same problem which are not discussing it over here. Then the limited liability partnership, there also similar problems are there. And then in the undue family is concerned, there also all these issues are there. You are liable for the trust, succession of business. The principle is the same, that where it is liability is there, then it will issue the notice to you. Ultimately you have to prove that you acted as a bona fide. And why I am referring for this reason, recently somebody came to us, he was the director, earlier NRIs were directors. He said the company had used money and all the two NRI directors liquidated and gone away. Now the liability has come on the Indian director, there is no business, no asset. But still he has to liquidate from his personal asset to pay to the department, then he has to come out on 79 instance. Ultimately he may proceed again the director, but a very lengthy process. That is how the 179 works is concerned. Now you see that what are the remedies for the again the recovery various authorities. In between I referred it for you what reply to the assessing officer. Now we will find there are circulars on this. Now you know 96 21A Deepak report. Then there is also circular 1970 that is not reported anywhere, but it reproduced in the 182 IGN 413. It says that the then Minister of Revenue given some assurance in Lok Sabha, what circumstances will not do it. Then there are 3-4 circulars, 334, 530, 194, 1944 is concerned. I just given you for your reference so that you may refer it when you give the reply is concerned. Now while appeal to the CAT appeal is concerned, is the power of the stay with CAT appeal? The answer is yes, because there are various case laws on this. 208 ITR, 212 ITR, 208 and 279, all these courts are laid down that CAT appeal has power for the stay. Why I am referring for this reason, once you file appeal to the CAT appeal, it is always preferable that you should also make application stay before him. Let him pass the order, let him keep the pending. Once it is keeping pending, then officer cannot recover. Once you reject that, either your remedy going to the High Court or we can go to the, I am not sure whether when he passes the order, then possibly we may approach the tribunal also again, that order is in order. And if it doesn't pass, the department cannot recover. Therefore, it is always advisable whenever you make an application. Now, interestingly, that Bombay High Court, because earlier we didn't have the judgment of the Bombay High Court, now we are having judgment of that 76 DTR 132, which I made reference to it over here. The Bombay High Court has recognized that the commissioner appeal has the power to deal with the matters, and tribunal has to go on to this extent that the Bombay High Court is that you have to pass a speaking order, then only can proceed further. Therefore, now I don't think any commission appeal can say that, no, I have no power for dispose of your stay petition is concerned, because of Bombay High Court, that commission appeal has the power. So therefore, if you go to the Bombay High Court, now you have the power, so dispose of, either he has passed the order or he may try to take your matter after term hearing, then only I think that will help you for the recovery is concerned. Now the, let me deal with the power for the tribunal for stay is concerned. Now the rule 35, Income Tax Appellate Tribunal rules, that deals with the, but there is no specific form in the Income Tax Act called the rules to which should be, what should be the 83 TTJ, that is the tribunal, Allahabad tribunal, said that they all right, you not have the form, though they prescribed in the, you are not in the rules by appendix, but you can be, anything you file it, if it is that, then the commissioner has to take into consideration, that is what. Now you see that the, now the, recently what we found that the very few matters are coming for the tribunal for the stay, reason being very simple, that the, nowadays when you file the appeal, that the, it, you will get the notice within 1 year, at least in Mumbai, therefore that the chances of the going to stay, but normally in January, February, March, you will get the number of stay petitions are much more, and then the, you will get the, from the tribunal is concerned, once you file the petition before the tribunal is concerned, that the, that is the, no officer can take any course action till the petition is disposed of by the tribunal. Now let me also share with you that the, these are all some of judgment which are given it, that the, when the, what time, what type of the cases where tribunal can consider. In one of the matters, the tribunal, it has been, though stay petition not filed. So I am referring to that, under the rules of Income Tax Tribunal, you can file the appeal if it is last day, even at the residence of the members are concerned, or register. Applying the same principle, by any last day, suppose your officer trying to recover you tomorrow morning, and you are not able to produce that, because if you file normal course, it may take some time, take channel. Then if you can give the stay petition at the residence of the member itself, and if you write to the income tax officer stating that, yes, I filed a stay petition before the tribunal, and hand it over to them, now you don't proceed. I don't think any officer can take action against the, stating that, no, your stay petition is not filed. So that way, emergency, possibly may give night to the, knock the doors of the members, and you can get the stay from the members. Though it not stay, at least that once informed the officer, we will not proceed further to the recovery concern. Now in the emergency, suppose you may be not able to get the order from the tribunal immediately. What we can do is that in emergency, you can mention before the court that, yes, this is the position, officer like you to attach my bank account, so please give me the stay. The tribunal may say, all right, ask the DR. Then till the admission is concerned, they said, inform the officer, don't proceed further. In one of the cases, we mentioned before the court, this is the position, 10:30 department is going to attach bank account. So if it is getting numbered, every take at least 2 days, so we want the stay. Member said that, all right, what we can do? We request a member, ask the DR, inform by phone to the officer concerned, not proceed further. And the, when the, the SSC was very smart, he had the phone number of the officer concerned. The DR said that, I have no phone number. The SSC said, sir, here is the phone number. Member said, go outside, inform and come back, inform us. That is how the, you know, emergency, it is possible that the he may be able to get the stay from the tribunal in exceptional circumstances, but don't make it as a rule, I am telling you. It is an exceptional circumstances that it may be possible that we will be able to get the stay from the tribunal in an appropriate case like this, in the emergency is concerned. Now the tribunal also has the power for the extending the date, suppose by any reason if not able to get this, they can extend the date for further. Now only thing is that it's all the caseless, which possibly I think you'll be able to if you note down, I don't know whether you'll be able to note down or not, I think you'll circulate or afterwards will circulate this, because so many case laws are given, it may be very difficult for you to note down also. My time also running out, so therefore I will not refer this, because the, what I am going to say, the, I am only referring principle of the what laid down, they said, tribunal has power to extend the stay is concerned. And not only that, you know, tribunal has the power to stay the assessment proceedings also. Suppose for example that the 263 pass and you are appealing for the tribunal and you feel that you have a very good chance of succeeding in the 263, again the 263 order, you can pray before the tribunal, don't give the direction to the officer not to proceed further till the matter is served. And the we have come across, the tribunal can give the stay. Recently, Delhi High Court, we are having the 185 ITR, 98 ITR, 110 ITR, which is about, that is of the old judgment, where the, in the case of Delhi High Court, the tribunal has given the stay not to proceed because according to the tribunal, it will amount to multiplicity of the proceeding because you appear for the officer, you will raise the demand, you are going appeal. Again, this order department went to the High Court. Writ petition. The Delhi High Court says that the nothing doing, the tribunal had done correctly, otherwise the amount multiplicity of proceeding, therefore the order of the tribunal is justified. That is what the judgment is referred in the Income Tax Appellate Tribunal, that is ITA online ORG, the judgment has been referred. Now the suppose by any chance, if you get the stay from the tribunal, you will not comply with the direction, will be there. They said you will not comply with the direction, so we will not leave. This is what 264 ITR and also 70 ITD they laid down. Not only that, there is also instruction of the department, what is said that the whenever SS is not complying the direction, then the department will move to the application to the tribunal. This is the SSC not complied, therefore stay should be vacated. If that is that happens, then I think you are assessing a difficulty, then bank will be attachment, no court sympathy will not be there. Of course, by any reason, if you are not able to comply, then only alternative left with the SSC, move once again petition to the tribunal, ask them to modify their direction, that may be possible. Otherwise, don't comply with that, then that difficulty will be there. Now, there is also the provision under the Income Tax Tribunal. You see, as per the minutes which were done 18-4-2012, where the President passed the order stating that the all covered matter will be taken out of hearing, appeal against 263, especially 263, why I am referring, the suppose the if you file the appeal, if it comes for after, let us say, after 1.5 years, there is no purpose to serve. If you can make application that all right, this is the 263 appeal, then they will fix out of turn hearing, so your entire exercise of once again going to officer will not be there. Similarly, the ex parte order, let us say CNF pass the ex parte order, you are in appeal. You make an application, it will take an out of turn hearing, so disposal will be very quick. Similarly, the senior citizens of above 70 years, then also that will be taken out of turn hearing. So now this is the what the tribunal is concerned, where you can able to. But recently, I am also sharing with you one point before I proceed. One or two issues on the other issues. One is that the suppose recently the where the e-tribunal started, that is the concept developed by the Mumbai ITAT. Suppose Nagpur you are having the matter and you are not able to come over here, you can sit at Nagpur and matter will be heard over here for early fixing of the matter, or if a stay is concerned. But suppose because Nagpur, why we say that Nagpur? Nagpur where may not be in bench at all. So if you want the stay, how will you do it? You can file the petition in Nagpur, matter will be heard at Mumbai by electronically, and it will be the stay will be granted from Mumbai. Similarly, by any chance, suppose if you are SSC, let us say from some places where there is no bench at all sitting, members are not there. You can move an application to the president over here. You have filed application, let it be heard in Mumbai, then the president will give direction that all right, the it will be heard in Mumbai and it will be decided accordingly. So this, as a stay is concerned, I think you'll be able to get it, the stay from the tribunal is concerned based on this. Now Sikh industrial company, there are judgment on this, various courts are laid down that the if a Sikh company, the Sikh provisions of the Sikh industrial company override income tax act, they cannot recover it unless they take permission from the competent of what is concerned. This is all the all these case laws directly on the point that is said that they cannot recover. Now 281, this is one of the point which is very important for this, I think BCA also may have to consider. What you see that the circular says that explaining the provision, you transfer certain property to overcome the tax acquired proceeding, entire transfer becomes the void. 3281 is concerned. Now the issue comes here that the all right, the if you do it before the assessment order pass, then it will not become void. And if it is passed after assessment is concerned, you are likely to get, then it may be void. That is what the courts have laid down on this issue is concerned. Now the issue comes over here, the one interestingly, the direct taxes code, what they have gone to this extent, that the suppose if you transfer the property to your wife or to your son when he was a minor, then the according to the direct tax code, that the department can challenge it any time, even after attaining majority also, that can be recorded from the, according to them it will be void. This provision is not there under present, the present schedule is not there, it is only there in the, your direct taxes code is concerned. This provision is there, that is very very dangerous provision, but anyhow that is provision, and though we have made little representation, you could not able to succeed much with the department to exclude that. That is what the direct tax code rule 3-2, what specifically says that the in respect of area due from defaulter for the period attaining majority by the minor child, property shall continue being called defaulter's movable immovable property even after that day. Suppose it become major, still it can be recovered. This is the one, there is no time limit at all, it may be after 15 years or it may be for 20 years, still this is one of very dangerous provision which will file in the direct tax code is concerned. Of course, priority of the revenue is concerned, that is very simple. Now the power of arrest, you know, this is the one of the provision you will find under the under the attachment is concerned, wherein under rule 72, revenue can resort to the attachment and arrest simultaneously. Not necessary that you will attach it and not recover. He may do both together. He can try to arrest you, he can also try to attach your property is concerned. Similarly, for the HOP is concerned, the rule 73, explanation what they added there says that the for purpose of this rule, the defaulter is the younger family, Karta can be liable for the arrest. Not other member, at least Karta can be. Similarly, partner is concerned, the acting partner or maybe held liable for the arrest is concerned. But there are certain exceptions, like you know that the woman is exempt from the arrest. If you are attending the court, then the exemption will be there. Like this, but once you pay the tax, then there will not be an arrest is concerned. That is the what laid down as regard the rule is concerned. I think that the last issue what I thought of touching only the accountability provision, what Deepak mentioned it over here. Thereafter we will go for question and answer. Now here this is one of the provision I think BCA can play a very proactive role, because recently we have seen that SS code, most of the BCA's suggestion has been considered by them. Now what we are asking, very simple, that the you bring the accountability provision in the act. If you bring the accountability, possibly all these huge additions are likely to suffer, that will not be there. And if there is no huge additions are not there, then the recovery problem also may not be there. This is the one provision possible I think all of us has to make very very serious attempt, at least bring in the next finance bill and impress upon that the we are having the Dr. Somu is one of the nice person, we able to convince him, I think then possibly the we will able to succeed very very very. And another is that the all the orders should be made appealable, you know, like that. Commissioners, why should have litigation on that? If give the power to the commission appeal, like 179, now you have to go to the court, make appeal to the tribunal, then this all these issues what otherwise would have sorted out by the tribunal level, that can be a release the. Now fortunately, one good thing for all of you, so we are having a very good tax bench now, where the both the we are having two tax benches now, one for expedition and one for the reference. Both the benches are well conversant with the tax. All these case laws which are referred it over, they have been passed by the respective benches. So if you are having something very very difficult situation or approaching the court, you will have the very good case of that, because at least bench knows the problem. This also I mentioned earlier, the bench has noted that general paper remarks are very difficult, what the issue is, and you may get the stay from the High Court And I am also hopeful that the at least if the EP continues further, possibly that the one of the courts may say that all right, in spite of our repeated, we are not acted upon, why contempt should not be taken again one of the officer. If at least one officer is held responsible, possibly I think all this harassment which you may otherwise have to face by your assessment may have to face, still may not be arise. With this, thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. And I of course, no doubt, I have gone a little bit very fast, because otherwise I could not have completed the what I wanted to complete. Yes, because in fact we should have the question answer, because the question answer is the only one forum where I always like it, because the always the new issues come from the participant. Thank you very much. Thank you, Deepak. Thank you. Once again to the 2 days. Possibly you were actually should have approached the court, they would have got the relief. That is the only way. There is no other way. No, property of the spouse, if it is from our own income or she has tax, cannot be attached. Yes, that is what I refer to the Supreme Court judgment from the private limited company converted into limited company. From date of conversion, they are not liable. But suppose the old liability is there, then definitely I can go against the old directors. That is the court, because normally, you know, when they converted into that limited company, the court permission is required, you know, when they go. When the court is approved by the court, the presumption is that it is not malafide. It is, Allah, the court will not approve it at all. What? No. Limited? No. I am referring quoted company. I am referring of quoted, not of the, not dimmed. I am referring only this one. Property, in case of HGM, suppose the person
played his master in the name of HGM, but he was in the name of Yadda.
Yes, for the when the HF was in existence, suppose liability of the HF comes, then they can attach the property, which suppose is after the HF, the partition has taken place, property has come to the members.
No partition is taking place except that the property is being transferred in the name of
HF. Hmm. Again, the karta or individual or is the HF? What?
Recovery proceedings for individual.
Okay.
So we transferred it.
During the proceedings of assessment, the whole property, say, greater than transferred in the name of HF.
But is it by sale or what? No, that if they then possibly know that officer may try to recover, because if it is like this, suppose if it is for consideration, then there is no point, then they cannot recover, if it is for consideration. If it is without consideration, then it is automatically covered under. Yeah, 281 covers that. That's.
So when the assessment order came,
filing copy of the dispute resolution manual,
Then your remedy is going to the tribunal. Yes, yes, not to the, not to the state. No. You can directly approach to the tribunal only, because once the first appellate, once the DRP passed the order, of course, no doubt the, you can approach the officer for give the installment. You will, I don't think any officer will give you that. You can directly approach the tribunal, and tribunal give the stay on that.
No, not at all.
Because that is what the so many case laws on this. When the stay petition is pending, the officer cannot attach, cannot take any action. But only thing is, provided you inform him.
Yes.
You see, you have to give the copy to him, because normally in the procedure like this, once you file the stay petition, the immediately tribunal gives the date. Normally, suppose today if you file it, next Friday you'll get the date. So if you inform them, my stay petition is filed, and then the fees for hearing such and such a date, I don't think any officer will do it. In fact, one of the cases where stay petition was pending, officer recovered, the tribunal directed them to refund the, in fact, deposit back to the bank. Then the order passed against the officer.
That circular 96
is still valid. Circular 96 is not still valid, but courts have considered that, that will be looked into that. One of the case laws they referred it, it is not valid. It has been, what department argue, always argues that it has been withdrawn or the modified, but courts are taking cognizance of that. They say that though it is withdrawn, but still principle should be applied. And so 2-3 cases, what I referred, they have considered that once again, and they laid down the principle is concerned.
Yes.
No, 282 now they amended, up to 2009 it was not permitted. Now they say that the, as per the Information Technology Act, what is permitted, that can, like courier, it was not there earlier. Now they amended the rule, 282, if you see, as per the Information Technology Act, if it is valid service, then it is valid. We have to see that whether they covered under that. The Texas court, they want to cover much more broader, but here they say that as per Information Technology Act, what if the service is valid, then it can be considered as valid service.
Means after 2009?
After 2009. Before that, absolutely no.
Yes, sir.
That is very clear.
And second thing, rectification application. If I have filed the rectification application, whether I can file the appeal,
as well? Yes, you should. According to me, that once you file rectification application, you should also go appeal to the state appeal, you know. Suppose if it doesn't do it. And then you should also say that, yes, this is my application pending, and don't proceed further on the recovery also.
So,
both you have to do.
I can do both.
You have to do both.
Thank you.
Sir, I got news from government companies, and I say I do withdraw those views rather than attach your bank account.
Yes, okay, Dalal, I think. it is twice is not with you, you know. See, like this. 226 is that, not that you can ask them, you have no, it is for them to do it. You cannot tell them, all right, suppose let us say that something due from Gautam Naik, then you go, Gautam is very sound, so then that is not possible, you know. That is left to them to decide where to go. That is not possible. Yes.
Salary?
Receivable.
Yes, it can be attached, subject to certain restrictions. No, they say that up to, not entire salary, portion of the, suppose they have given that only like director. Suppose director, if you are director in 179, there are case laws, suppose you join some other company afterwards. Your salary can be attached, subject to certain limit, not the entire salary, they cannot take away. Subject to that, they can do it.
Can I make a proposal?
Of course, definitely. You can make the proposal and they may consider it and they may give the installments also. Yes, please.
Sir, settlement commission passed order under 245(4), then the huge tax was payable. So the income tax department decided to give granted pay in installment quarterly. And the last date was 31st March 2013 suppose. And the applicant failed to pay the first and second installment due to investigation in irrigation department and irregularity form. So now whether the applicant can say there is a stay proceeding or whether the bank accounts can be attached or not.
No, if you file a settlement petition, is it admitted or is it for finding for final hearing? What? No, is it admitted? D1 order passed or no?
Yes, sir.
D1 has been passed. But D1 has passed the order, then settlement commission can give the stay installment. You know, suppose if you not admitted till that time, you cannot approach the then normal procedure.
And then whether the case lies with the settlement commission or.
No, once the D1 is passed, the entire thing lying with the different settlement commission. They have full authority on the entire case. Till the D1 is concerned, no.
And whether we can challenge, since the last date of installment was 31st March, we can challenge that it cannot be attached before 31st March.
Where will challenge?
For the installment?
No. You have to go approach the same authority. No? Like this. Suppose the officer has given you the installment due, okay? Then you have to approach him only to the relax the installment, whatever may be. If he is not doing, you can approach the settlement commission. Suppose by any chance settlement commission also not doing, then all your remedy is going to the court is concerned. I am not in a position to pay, you may say it is whatever the reason. He can. Not that they are bound, but he can. Remedy approach the tribunal for stay. That is the only. If a good case, then I think. But normally, of course, in fact, I thought of, you know, like by any chance, you know, when you approach the tribunal, you are not in a position to make the payment. The tribunal normally gives the early hearing. That is one. But that is not a solution for you. So one way could be, if you are able to convince the bench, all right, if you let us say they are ready to give you the suppose simple matter I am telling, maybe covered matter or maybe you could request the bench, all right, don't reject my stay, give me early hearing, that both will be out together. Then at least the department cannot recover from you. Because that when stay is pending, they cannot recover. Your stay once rejected, they can recover.
Last question.
Yes, that could be considered. They have to. That is what the financial hardship is one of the reasons. Financial hardship is suppose if you are having suppose huge cash balance, then that
cannot be the financial hardship.
Suppose you
suppose if you are letting out money in the bank, you will not pay wages to your employee.